Okay. And this argument may be correct or may be wrong. Okay. So good evening, all of you. In this special session, where we're going to speak about GMAT as well as CAT, I think the most important problem that a lot of students face is how do we choose whether one should write a CAT exam, one should write a GMAT exam, which institutes in the country and abroad use GMAT and or a CAT for their admission processes. Okay, so that my entire session today is going to make sure that you understand, depending on who you are, depending on what your background is, and depending on what your aspirations are. Please understand that it depends on all these before you kind of finally decide that. Okay, both these exams are typically entrance examinations. Entrance examinations to what? Entrance examinations to MBA colleges. So when you're talking about MBA colleges, they are either in India or abroad. In India, the top colleges like the IIMs take CAT as their the common admission test as their written test. If you look at world over, the best institutes in the US or in Europe, whether it is the Harvard Business School, the Stanford Business School, the Wharton School, or the Booth School of Business in Chicago, or in London School of Business, or INSEAD in Paris, there are n number of good colleges and good B schools. They are called B schools, business schools. Dime a dozen actually in the world, all of them take an exam called a GMAT for their entrance. How exactly do you decide? I think over the next 45 minutes to 1 hour maximum, we will spend time today, and if you have more questions, I'll be very only glad to answer this. My name is ARKS, A-R-K-S Srinivas. I'm the CEO of the entire CL MBA programs. I'm also an alumnus of IIM-Calcutta way back in 1993. And for the last 18 years, I have been training students in CAT, GRE, and GMAT, among with, of course, being a career counselor myself. Okay. As said, in this session, let's look at what is it that is different about GMAT and CAT, and why do you use each one of them? Now, if you look at GMAT, GMAT, a lot of people are asking the same question, is a written test for MBA in the world's top B schools, Harvard, Wharton, Stanford, Columbia, INSEAD, London School of Business, National University of Singapore, NUS, Nanyang Tech, CEIBS in Shanghai. You can name the world's B schools, some of the best B schools in the world, the top 100, let's put it that way, take GMAT as a written test. Even Indian B schools, one of the best B schools, no, take GMAT scores is ISB, Indian School of Business, which is in Hyderabad. Then the IIM, the Indian Institutes of Management, A, B, C, L, XL, L, I, all of these also have an MBA program, typically a 1 year MBA program. It's called the PGPX program, for which the written test is the written test to get entry into that itself is GMAT. You can see clearly on the screen XLRI, the 1 year program, SPJN, which takes for both 1 year and 2 years, NMIMS, again for the 1 year program, GLIM, both for 1 and 2 years, MDI for their 1 year program. So typically a 1 year programs use the GMAT exam in India. There are of course exceptions to this rule. If you are an NRI, you can apply to the IIMs also and some of the other institutes also through the GMAT exam too. Okay, so if you understand, when somebody says should I write GMAT, should I write CAT, one obvious thing here, CAT, if you look at it, the best schools in the country, in India, all the 2 year programs and of course the fellow programs in management use CAT as their written test. As you can see, IIMs, SPJN, FMS, MBI, JBIMS, Jamnal Lal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies. Those of you who do not know FMS, FMS is in Delhi, Faculty of Management Studies, Delhi. SPJN is in Mumbai. MDI is Gurgaon. IITs, all the IITs have a two-year program for MBA. NITI, that's in Bombay, which is a National Institute of Industrial Engineering. This is basically a supply chain management program. Of course, they have other things also. Best for operations management. IIT Ghaziabad, IMI Delhi, all of them take CAT as their written test. There are other top B schools in India, like XLRI in Jamshedpur, which has their own exam called XAT, the Xavier's Aptitude Test. There's an institute in Bombay called NMIMS, Narsimonji, which takes an exam called NMAT, or SIBM in Pune, which takes an exam called SNAP. Now, if you can, Himanshu, I'll answer that question. I will answer that question, Madhuri. GMAT and CAT. There is GMAT and CAT, which is very, very simply for you to understand. In a nutshell, all abroad programs, the best abroad programs in the world, for you to apply, you need to have a GMAT score. Similarly, the best schools in the country, in India, you need to have a CAT score. Of course, a couple of other things as that NAP and NMAT too. For all one-year programs, even in India, obviously abroad it's obvious, even in India, GMAT is the exam for it. So now somebody asks, sir, boss, what should I do, CAT or GMAT? My answer would be, or my first question would be, yaar, tumko India mein karna hai ya outside India mein karna hai? If you want to do it in India, very clearly, it is the CAT exam which needs to be put up. If you are talking about going abroad and writing, it's a GMAT score that is very, very important. Therefore, you need to write an exam called GMAT. Obviously, there is an overlap in this. There is an overlap between the one-year programs which take the GMAT scores also. Let's understand that a little further. Before you decide whether you should do GMAT or CAT, somebody asking GRE. GRE also is used by a lot of US business schools. Even ISB uses GRE for their entry. But all European schools only take GMAT as of today. You understand? So in that sense, pehle ye hota tha ki GRE could not be used for MBA programs, but now it can be used also. Okay? Now anyway, coming back to very, very simple questions. Again, Gehna, there are two different exams. GRE is another exam conducted by ETS. GMAT is another exam conducted by the GMAT Council. Okay, we will consider that. I'm sure a lot of questions will keep coming in. If you can just hold on for a few minutes, you will see that a lot of these questions will get answered by my presentation itself. Now, how do you decide whether to go for a CAT or a GMAT? The factors to consider is the course itself. The next is the work experience, then the financials and the fees. Obviously, when you talk about financials, you look at the fees, the money that you need to spend for staying for 2 years or 1 year, depending on where you do it. The placements at the end of 1 hour or 2 years, depending on which program you join. Clearly, these are some things which everyone needs to consider. And of course, last but not the least, what kind of a career progress can you expect at the end of finishing this course? Not only finishing this course, not only the entry levels, but also levels for further growth in your career as such. So these are the four basic areas or four basic factors one would need to choose one of these courses. Let's look at, this is very, very important. Lots of people are asking. Himanshu Yadav has been asking this question, why for MIM versus MBA kind of things. I keep saying this, my friends. Hold on for 5-10 minutes. All the questions will be answered. Now, coming back to this, the course. If you take up CAT, typically this for a 2-year residential program in the IIMs and all the top institutes in the country. You will get an MBA degree or a PGDM. By the way, both are absolutely equivalent. Yes, Akash, both of them are very equivalent. In fact, probably the IIM PGDM, though it is called a diploma, could be probably better off and has a more value than the degree. In our country, a degree, an MBA degree can be given only by a university. So, for example, the FMS, the Faculty of Management Studies, comes under University of Delhi, and hence it gives you an MBA. Symbiosis, SIBM, because it's under Symbiosis University, gives an MBA. IIFT is a deemed university, therefore it gives an MBA in international business. But SP Jain, MDI, IIMs, most of the other institutes, what they give only a diploma because they are not a university. Having said this, they are very, very similar. I mean, in fact, the PGDM is completely equivalent and there is zero difference between that and MBA as far as India is concerned. Whereas if you look at a GMAT, if you write, you can apply for an MIM program, that is Masters in Management program, or you can write an MBA program. As you can see the next slide, in the next point, typically Masters in program or Masters in Management is for lesser work experience. Anybody with less than 2 years of or 3 years of work experience should apply for an MIM program. In fact, MIM program or the Masters in Management program has started only in the recent past. The MBA program was the most important or the known program across the world. But why are the US universities starting MIM program? Because of Indians. All Indians who have a lot of money want to go to MIM. There is no option for MIM in India. It's an MBA program, that's all. MIM in India, in the US, is opened specifically for people from India or China or Pakistan or Bangladesh, it looks like. Simply because all these guys have a lot of tons of money, they want to go off to the US. They can't wait for working for 2-3 years, and therefore you can directly get admission after your graduation itself. In India, it's called graduation. In the US, it's called undergraduation. Okay, so what is the difference between these two? Yes, of course there is a difference. MBA, typically, the average age of a student doing an MBA in US is 28 or 29 years, whereas for MIM program, it is about 24, 25 years in that sense. There is a difference in the curriculum for MIM versus MBA program. In fact, a lot of MBA programs, of course, in the US, they are all 2-year programs. But if you look at the programs in the US, in Europe, all these MBA programs are actually 1-year programs, not even 2-year programs. In general, these guys expect you to have more than 5-6 years of experience. And then you can apply for it. That's why almost you cannot apply or you cannot get into these very, very good schools unless you have that minimum of 4-5 years of experience. To overcome such a problem, and the US universities wanted Indian students also, and quite a lot of other students, I mean Chinese students also, they have started a program called the MIM, the Masters in Management program, such a way that even graduates, freshers can also join. Is there a difference in the curriculum? Yes, partially there is a difference in the curriculum, because the lot of MBA programs will have a lot of strategy and slightly more. One second. I think these guys all participants. Okay. Guys, Gehna, Saurabh, Ronit, may I just ask you, just hold on for 15 minutes. Yeah, all questions will get answered if you can wait for. So Kishan, can you wait, all of you guys? I mean, I understand a lot of you are there with a lot of questions. Since it's not individual that you are, while you can see only your name, there are more than 200 students in this particular webinar session. Therefore, may I just request all of you to hold on your questions for the next 20 minutes. After that, you please flood me with questions by my colleague Srinivas, and I will try to answer as many as possible. Okay, just give me, I think why I'm saying so. Simply because with so many questions, and when you guys ask questions, it becomes a disturbance for me. That's all. Disturbance because it keep popping up all the questions. Just relax. 10 minutes, take it out. Great. So MIM program is a master's in management program, typically for a 2-year program, again for people less than 2 years of work experience. Even freshers from India can apply to this program. Even then you need to write your GMAT exam. Anyway, ideally for more than 3 years experience, and average for more than 5 years experience, either in Europe or in the US. There is obviously a difference in the curriculum, but by and large, the curriculum remains the same. The only possible difference that I can think of is at the level of strategy that is there in MBA versus MIM, because MBA programs, I already told you, I'm talking about GMAT, I mean abroad, people with 5 years experience come in, they will come with a lot of experience already. So therefore, when somebody discusses strategy in the classes, I think they are able to understand it much better. That's all. In CAT, through CAT that is, it is MBA degree is also for freshers. There is no problem at all. Okay. We'll see that in the next slide very clearly. What is the work experience required to get there? CAT, there is no minimum requirement. If you have, you get marks. Ideally, I wouldn't expect people with more than 5 years to write CAT at all. Not because the IIMs do not take them. It's just that you will be, out of the 400 students, you will be less than 3 or 4 students in the entire batch. So therefore, getting placements in such kind of a scenario is not going to be easy. As we said, CAT is suited for between 0 to 3 years experience. And if you have more than 4 years or 5 years of experience, a 1 year MBA abroad or 1 year MBA in India is the best choice. Whereas in GMAT, for MIM program, I already told you work experience will be 0 to 2. For MBA programs, minimum 2 to 3, but recommended 6 to 7 year programs. That is 2 year programs in the US. And in fact, let me also tell you right now, those of you who have more than 8 years experience, there are programs in the US which are 11 months programs, which are, they call it 1 year programs, which are minimum for a 10 year experience guy. There is one in Sloan School of Management, typically a leadership program. People with 10 plus years of experience apply to this. The minimum age is 35 years. The maximum age could be 45, 50 kind of things. Probably I can apply there in that sense of the word. That's the kind of a programs available at the very top level of management also. Okay, so in that sense of the word, wherever you are guys, whether you are in graduation, finished graduation, 1 year experience, 5 years experience, even 10 years experience, the best thing in life is there are choices available for you. And for a lot of people, the choices in India are through CAT and GMAT. For abroad, obviously through GMAT exam as such. Now let's look at financials, how costly it is for fees as such. Financials, all figures are in Indian rupees, my friends. For CAT, the 2 year fees including stay and food, depending on college to college, can range between 12 lakhs to 24 lakhs. The IIMs, the ABCs of the world now charge 21 lakhs totally, plus the total everything including all your personal life will be 24 lakhs is what expected. The new IIMs are in the 12 to 14 lakhs range. The top IIMs are in the 16 to 24, like IIM Kozhikode is 17 lakhs, IIM Indore is 30 lakhs. Of course, the ABCLs are in the 19 to 21 lakhs range. Many top private B schools are in the 12 to 22 lakh range. For example, IMI, IMT, all are in the 19 lakh bracket. Whereas the 1 year programs fees are between 15 to 35. ISB is at 35 lakhs. Whereas let's say SPJM is at 15 lakhs in that sense. ISB, top rated for the 1 year program, costs around 35 lakhs for all things. It's for 1 year, guys. Just about 11 months, not even fully 1 year. The IIMs also, PGPX programs, cost you 25 lakhs for the 1 year program. This is for the PGPX program. That is the executive MBA program, as they call it. Other top colleges like GLIM, etc., will be in the range of, and SPJN will be in the range of 15 to 22 lakhs, all inclusive. This is my fees. In general, if you get into any of these top institutes, you can be almost assured that you will get a loan also. So don't worry about that loan. Lots of people worry about loan and don't even apply. You will see that in India, at least, you will get loans for these things. When you talk about GMAT, it depends on a country and a college. Somebody asked me Germany. Akash, I think, asked me Germany. Clearly, in Germany, when you go itself, while it could be costly, there is a very high possibility of, if you get there, to get a kind of a scholarship or a rebate in your fees in that sense. But the number of seats available in a place like Germany are going to be very low as compared to UK, that is United Kingdom, that is Britain or London, or for that matter, the US itself. So clearly there is no way there is one single fees. A two-year MBA in the US could cost anywhere between 20 lakhs and 80 lakhs. 20 lakhs for the, let's say, the 100th ranked institute to 80 lakhs for the top ranked institute, almost. A two-year MIM program can range between 15 lakhs and 40 lakhs. Clearly, the MIM program is considered slightly inferior. Therefore, the jobs that you get are also not at the top level kind of things. You are right, Akash. Absolutely correct. In fact, Akash is sending a message here saying that many German colleges do not even have tuition fees as far as I know. Absolutely correct, provided you get there. That's what I'm saying. They give a huge rebates in Germany, provided you get there kind of things. You need to be very fluent in German too, by the way. Okay, so this is the kind of a fees that one has to go in when you are talking about it. And the last thing is about 1 year MBA programs. Some of the MBA programs in US can cost close to 1 crore also. That's the huge amount of money that you might pay. But wait, hold on. 1 crore may mean $125,000 or something close to $150,000 in that sense. But please also realize that the first job that you get will also be in the $150,000 or even $250,000. So in that sense, quarter of a million that you're getting at the end of 1 year, I think spending 1 crore at that point of time should not be a major issue in that sense, provided you have the money to spend to begin with. And remember this, it is not that easy to get into such kind of institutes. You need to have a fantastic record, academic record, and a fantastic non-academic record also, extracurriculars, co-curriculars, and add to that a very, very good track record of your work experience. Okay, so that's the financials and fees. The other thing is important for what will you get at the end of 1 year? Placement at the end of 1 year or 2 years, depending on where you do it. Academics means 10th, 12th degree, everything. Now, for placements, CAT, the two-year MBA average salaries are between 10 lakhs and 24 lakhs, depending on colleges. Once again, the top IIMs, if you look at IIM, Kozhikode, Indore, etc., on an average, see, please notice one thing. This is the average fees. Salaries, 17 lakhs to 24 lakhs. That does not mean everybody gets 17 lakhs. There are people who get 10 lakhs also in IIM, Kozhikode of the world. There are people who get, there is no 1 year program for MIM Madhuri. There is a 2 year, 1 year for MBA. There are two, the MIMs are all 2 year programs typically. So anyway, so coming back to CAT, top IIMs, the average salaries can be 17 and 24 lakhs salaries at the end of 1 year. Top private colleges also could be between 15 and 22, like SPJN, MDI Gurgaon,
you know, NITI is not a private college, of course. IIFT is not a private college, but all of them will have in that range. Others can have in the range of 10 to 15. I'm talking about all the top 30, 40 colleges. There are colleges which will give you 5 lakhs also. That's a different issue. 1 year average salaries can again range between 12 lakhs to 28 lakhs. Great Lakes Institute of Management probably gives you about 12 to 14 lakhs, whereas an ISB gives you 28 lakhs. FMS Anil is a 2 year program in MBA. The fees will be less than a lakh rupees because it's a University of Delhi fees. Top IIMs, the average salary again in PGPX programs, about 24 to 28. ISB again was 22 lakhs, 20 to 24 lakhs. Other colleges' average obviously reduces. GMAT, the top MIM 2 year program average could be as high as 35 lakhs to 65 lakhs. But please realize, 35 lakh is only $55,000-$60,000. 65 lakhs is $100,000. There's a difference. So when somebody looks at it, we understand that $100,000 is not very, very high if you do an MIM program in the US. Whereas if you look at MBA programs, you get anything between $100,000 to even $200,000. That is the difference between MIM. So people, Nitesh, MIM is Masters in Management program. Masters in Management program for people with less than 2 years of experience abroad. That is not in India. Okay. So can you understand? So therefore, very clearly, if you don't have the patience to wait for 2-3 years and work and do an MBA abroad, and you want to do your MBA, so to say, abroad immediately, you can't do an MBA, but a very equivalent program called MIM, the Masters in Management program, can be done. And probably you'll get about 35 to 40, but in dollars, please realize this. So convert that into dollars. It could be almost similar to what an MS person gets from the top institutes. MS is Masters in Science. Whereas MBA has a significant advantage of even a very, very high or a better placement at the end of 2 years. Even the 1 year programs at the end of things is minimum of 65 lakhs almost, and it can go up to 1.5 crores on the minimum. This is, again, I'm talking about averages. Please understand that there could be a person with a fantastic background and record and, you know, earning $1 million at the end of 1 year programs also. But again, I'm talking about averages. People like you and me probably. I mean, I'm not saying all of you are average. My apologies for that if you are better. But I would say if I were there, kind of things. Okay, right. With that in mind, let's look at the next part of the right idea. What is it that you would get in a 2 year program? What is the career progress like, and how is it like for CAT or for institutes in India? You get entry into the mid-level managers. You will not be at the bottom level, but you will be starting off at the mid-level managers straight away. That's the reason why a TCS, Tata Consultancy Services, when it goes to the top IIMs, pays about 13, 14 lakhs. It goes to, let's say, an IIM, newer IIMs, it still pays about 10 lakhs, 10, 12 lakhs kind of things. If they go to an engineering college, mind you, they pay hardly 3.5, 4 lakhs. In fact, 2 years experience guy for an TCS gets 3.75 lakhs, whereas finishing an MBA and getting into the same TCS, even from a very average college, you can get about 10 lakhs. That is the kind of a difference between not doing MBA and doing an MBA. Through CAT, the career progress is very simple. Would reach your decision-making position in about 4 to 5 years. Average CAGR is, CAGR, by the way, those of you don't understand, is compounded annual growth rate, is 15 to 20%. That means if you look at for 5 to 10 years of experience or growth, on an average, you will grow by 15 to 20% if you have an MBA from any of the top institutes in this country. And of course, if you keep switching jobs, a good hikes are possible for people who are through the CAT level MBA programs. You can reach your CXO position because you start off at 24, 25, you start off at 24, 25, you can reach a CXO position by 40 to 45 years of age. When you look at GMAT, obviously, again, varies. I think the difference between CAT and GMAT is GMAT is across. There are 200 countries in this world. And even Europe, there are programs, very good programs in UK, programs in France, programs in Spain, programs in Italy, Germany. I mean, you name the company, name the country in Europe, there are very, very good programs, including Denmark and Sweden probably. Similarly, in Australia, there are good programs. Singapore, there are good programs. China, there are good programs. So, I mean, when you talk about GMAT, suddenly you have a lot of choice depending on where you want to go. Canada, there are good programs. Entry to mid-level managers for MIM and mid-level to strategy leaders for MBA. That is the career progress when you start off with an MBA or an MIM. As you can clearly see, the MIM program abroad is very similar to the CAT program or the normal MBA program, the two-year MBA program in India also. Again, the average CGR remains very similar, and the hikes also are pretty good. Sometimes the hikes could be as high as 100% depending on expertise. In fact, a friend of mine had actually done this leadership program I was talking about. It's Sloan School of Management. He was a graduate from IIFT, incidentally, was working with a very good company called Abbott, was drawing a 15-20 lakh salary, finished 1 year MBA in Sloan, and is now at $250,000. It's like a huge jump, actually. And of course, you can also become a CXO of MNCs by the age of 45 to 50, right? That's the career progress, guys. So now, anybody who wants to take a decision, finally, my counseling has always been something very simple. Boss, you need to try. They can, unless you are very clear that boss, US nahi jana hai, Europe nahi jana hai, ya Canada nahi jana hai, New Zealand nahi jana hai, that's a different issue. You then have only CAT as your exam. Prepare seriously for it. Get into the best 30 institutes in the country. Make your life in India very, very well. But there are people who have already or have thought about going abroad to do their post-graduation. In our case, it's called, in the case of going abroad, it's called graduation. But from our understanding, it's post-graduation. If you're interested immediately after your graduation, you should look at an MIM program. But anyone with 2 to 3 years of experience or even more and are looking abroad should look at a GMAT exam and then go for a 2 year MBA. Those people in the 2 to 4 year period are in the Trishanku Swarga, as I call it. They are in the Trishanku Swarga position. You can write CAT also as well as GMAT also. And depending on which college finally you get, which B school you finally get the final selection, you can take a decision, right? Career progress, 1 year programs, very straight for CAT or GMAT, middle managers to strategy leaders. And obviously, if you are a 1 year programs, there will be employment contracts, severance packages, etc. All these things are also, because you are in a very senior position in that sense of the word, very clearly. You have to be clear about those things too. Now, this is where we come down to, let me answer a couple of questions that some people have. I think these are going to all participants anyway. Just you are answering that. Himanshu, please don't send it to only me. Please send it to panelists because Srinivas is waiting there. If you send it to only me, I won't be able to do that. So please send it to everybody or at least to my panelists. Okay? Can you just... fees are about 12 lakhs, Madhuri. I have said that. 1 year executive MBA programs, the fees are about 25 lakhs. Yes, Rahul, it does. Okay. Okay, I think Srinivas, I think they are coming to. Thank you, Himanshu. I think as long as it's coming to everybody, he's going to answer. MBA is extremely good, Shubham, if you are very clear about that. YLP program is for people who are in the final year of their degrees, my friend, whoever that is asking. Yes, Rishita. If for the final year students, you can write GMAT exam, apply for YLP, get through, have a deferred admission of 2 years and then take a decision whether you want to join that or not. But of course, you need to pay 1 lakh rupees as a deferment fees. Again, good GMAT score frankly depends on where you want to go. If you want to go into the top schools, it has to be 700 plus, 710 plus, very clearly.
Here is what I'm going to spend a little time, guys. After that, you can ask me a lot more questions too. The GMAT preparation, the preparation duration is 3 months of regular practice if you have already given aptitude tests earlier. If those of you have prepared for CAT and are preparing for CAT, I would say GMAT will become easier for you because the quantitative section is not far more easier in GMAT than in CAT. However, if you have not prepared for CAT, then you will need about 5 to 6 months of serious preparation. Especially people who have 4 years of experience and you are out of touch with studying, you will need that extra time kind of things. But 3 months, I would strongly believe, is more than sufficient if you are in touch with your basic aptitude. The biggest thing about GMAT is the critical reasoning, reading comprehension and the grammar, that is the verbal section as such. If you prepare seriously for CAT, I think with a little bit of help on critical reasoning, you can crack your GMAT also. Okay. As far as preparation material is concerned, what we do in our preparation for GMAT, the career launchers GMAT preparation, is we have the idea would be to do a weekly preparation by attending classes. Lot of practice problems have to be taught have to be solved, taught in the class. Clearly doubt clearance as you get your doubts clear, because there are conceptual doubts which will be there, not question doubts but conceptual doubts in every area, even critical reading, even reading comprehension, even in grammar. I think you need to get them solved. And of course, 6 to 8 mocks in the last 1.5 months before writing the exam would be very, very essential for making that exam, for cracking this GMAT exam. What do we offer, friends? We have a 3 month duration program. Every week, 2 to 3 classes will be there. The classes are, every class will have class materials and every topic will have a practice problems which are very relevant to what the GMAT exam has been over the period. The 3 original guides to GMAT will be given to you, courier to you. More than 1000 practice questions for in the form of sectional tests. There are basically 2 sections. Of course, the integrated reasoning section is another section which also is taken care of. And we are planning to give 7 Veritas. Veritas is an internationally acclaimed GMAT trainer. And we have a tie-up with Veritas. And we will give you 7 adaptive mocks of Veritas with our program. You don't have to pay anything extra for these kind of things. The faculty members who teach you, Gautam Puri sir, GP as he is called, ARKS, yours truly here, Gijo Srinivasan, IIM Calcutta, GP sir is IIM Bangalore, Shivku is again IIM Calcutta, Srinivas is the other colleague who is answering for you right now, he is IIM Indore, GB is Gautam Bava, he is IIM Calcutta, Neeraj Prasad is FMS, we have Siddharth Mehta, we have Ajay Zainar, again IIM Ahmedabad, Siddharth Mehta from XLRI. We have one of the amazing set of faculty members, both for CAT and for GMAT in that sense. How do we do this? Through this platform called the WebEx platform. As you are seeing, the classes will be done exactly this way, except that it will be question by question. You will have the questions also with you in front of you. And the faculty member solves as we teach in an actual classroom. It's a two-way interactive class. As you can see, only thing is you can't speak to me. I can speak to you. Likewise, you can ask questions. One of the things that we have really, really noticed, is when you are in an online program, there are 2 things which are very interesting. One, the student who comes online is a very serious student. He means business. Therefore, he or she is very, very interested, and therefore the quality of the class and the quality of questions will go up significantly. Therefore, the learning is very high. Second thing which we have noticed is that because it is anonymous, so to say, and you can directly ask me individually questions, like you can see privately, you can send me a question. For all participants, you can send me a question. You know, there is no worry that you can't answer. Somebody will laugh at you for asking a silly question. Chances are that everybody has the same question. In a classroom, probably that doesn't come out. That's the only thing that you need to be very, that's the reason why probably a two-way interactive class delivered on WebEx is becoming more and more famous. And then, of course, we ensure that if you have any doubt, there is on request, you have a doubt clearing session. Every class is recorded, like this class is getting recorded, so that you can go back and check all the questions that you wanted to get answered and you might have missed out. Concepts, the concepts can get reiterated in your own memory when you go back and look at them. And last, of course, we will ensure that enough webinars at regular intervals, whether it is statement of purpose, the application process, which B schools apply. See, again, somebody asked me, which B school should I apply, sir? I don't know. Unless I know what is your background, what is your 10th score, 12th score, degree score, aspiration value, where you are working, what is your CTC today, what is the CTC expectation, all these things become very, very important. And we will ensure that individually and as collectively, we take care of this kind of a process. In addition to this, one of the things that you need to realize is this program is, you will see that the class that comes online really makes sure that across the country, whether you are in Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, Chennai, Agartala, Jammu, doesn't matter where you are, I think it's a great platform to interact with like-minded people across the country. All the IIMs provide one-year MBA, all the top IIMs provide the PGPX program, friend. Somebody was asking that question. Now, here is what we do, friends. Our batch is starting on 24th of January. That is 24th is a Wednesday, if I'm not wrong. Yes, the classes are going to be between 9 and 11 p.m. in the night. Idea is you come back from college or office, have your dinner. Instead of wasting and seeing, spending time on WhatsApp and or a movie, I think utilize it properly between 9 to 11 classes. Full 2 hours, almost an interactive session like this can make a difference to you in your career itself by taking up not just GMAT, but also applying to one of the, obviously, the best B schools in the country. This is going to be 2 to 3 days a week so that you have planned for the entire week properly. Schedule will be uploaded 1 week in advance. So ensure that you can plan that week too. And of course, the books that we said will be couriered to you once we verify your address after your enrollment with us. The fees, the actual price for the online course is 35,000. But if you pay before 24th January, this is obviously Amazons and the Flipkarts and the Ubers have made our life miserable. Therefore, we need a discount to kickstart our campaign. We thought this is the best thing that we can do. So before the batch starts, if you pay, it is 30,000 only. 5,000 spent. This is including GST. GST, by the way, is 18%. So we get something like less than 22,000 in this less than 25,000, 26,000 for this entire thing. Okay. For CAT preparation, Himanshu, also we have online classes called the night classes, which have again about 30,000-35,000 as the total fees for CAT alone. You can also join for CAT plus GMAT also for about 40,000-45,000. I don't have the exact number kind of thing. I think Adarsh is asking some questions. Yes, Himanshu, you please talk to Srinivas, who is there. He will give you. Mrigan is asking, what are the job prospects after coming back from a US or abroad? There are good prospects. Plus, please understand that the prospects will be similar to what you have for Indian MBAs, or it may be lesser than Indian MBAs typically, unless you are from an Harvard or a Stanford kind of things. So keep that in mind, because Indian business schools or Indian corporates give value to Indian B schools much more. Jaitan Gautam, scholarships after GMAT are far less as compared to the GRE. Far lesser. They are not as many as you can think. But once you go to a college, especially if it's a two-year college, you can think of, getting a TA or a RA kind of thing. But I said this, if you have a very fantastic score in GMAT and have a very, very good application, when I'm using the word application, that you are a statement of purpose, etc., you can apply for a financial assistance also. I think a lot of questions are coming. Srinivas, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Because I think we need to figure out who is asking, because there are too many questions which are coming in, and I think we are missing out all the questions also. I think what I will do is, after this, I will give my email ID and your email ID. You have given. By the way, my friends, Srinivas, who is also answering your questions till now, his number is 9900022975. Ankita Jain, my colleague, who also gives a lot of information on our course, etc., is the number given there, 95995-58801. I am also going to give you my email ID and Srinivas's email ID so that you can mail us and we will get in touch with us. Srinivas's email ID is srinivas.a@careerlauncher.com. One second, I'll just add this here. You can see this, our Rajat Ahuja. I'll answer this question. If you prepare for CAT, it will be enough for a large extent, but for GMAT specifically, Rajat, you need a little bit more of verbal ability. The section of verbal ability in GMAT has critical reasoning much more than, let's say, the CAT exam. Hence, critical reasoning, a little bit of reading comprehension, which is slightly different from a CAT. Not really different, but similar to CAT. And grammar is again one third of the GMAT exam, whereas CAT does not have at all grammar these days. That extra bit of preparation has to be done. Somebody is asking whether they have 3-6 years of experience, what do I do kind of things. Srinivas, are you answering? I can't see any single answer of yours. Gurmandeep Singh Sutdar, what are the best schools, courses for supply chain in UK, US? I think we need to do a research and get back to you on that, friend. I don't have it offhand.
Questions directly to them individually.
Don't do that, na? They're asking the same questions again and again, na? When the question is coming, participant, please send it to the participant, na, please. It makes life easier also. Is there a presentation can get? The presentation will put it up on our YouTube channel, Satvik. Baba. No, not at all. It won't. Just one, it won't. Somebody is asking who's been our CS student with 6+ years of experience. Have you answered that question? HR chances depending on which college you go, my friend. That is absolutely. Ronit, you want to make your life in HR? Please remember that there is an XLRI in HR, TISS in HR, TASS, Tata Institute of Social Sciences in HR, which is very, very good. Likewise, a lot of colleges in the country, in abroad, have very, very good HR prospects too, depending on college. But please understand that it is not any college and every college. A lot of research has to be done before you go into applying to the right kind of college for your profile. Himanshu, you are in the first year. When should I start preparing for GMAT? First year of what? Engineering or degree?
Yes, Anubhav Walia, it is 9 to 11. For you, I would recommend Siddesh. Very clearly, CAT at this stage. No. For the price shown is only for GMAT. Okay, one other thing I'll tell you guys, because there are a lot of other questions coming in. May I request each one of you to send us individually, don't send two mails, send us one of us, Srinivas or me, a mail with your background, 10th, 12th degree, number of years of work experience, your CTC, if you have written CAT already before, give us the answer. We will definitely get back to you within 48 hours. ARKS, I have 5 years experience and end up scoring 93. What do I do? 1 year is advisable, right? Yes, absolutely, R. Absolutely, Ravi. You should do a 1 year MBA program. Since 93 percentile you have, I think you should start applying to some of these 1 year programs too. Next year, Himanshu. Shirish Gupta, just send me your details and ask me what exactly you need. I will definitely help you. No Harshvardhan, there is none. 50% is what they are looking at. No, you shouldn't risk leaving a job, Kishan. Definitely not. Satya Harish Kumar, please prepare for CAT and then write GMAT, not the reverse. Gehna, you please send a mail to me. You know, don't give your mail ID to me if you don't mind. Just send a mail to me with your the things. I will be very, very happy to reply you very quickly. 3 years, third year experience, Himanshu Yadav. I think you can write GCAT, but you should write GMAT. With 2 years, Rishita, CAT. GMAT could be one extra thing, but CAT is what you should still write one more year very clearly. Nishit Kumar, see, once you write the GMAT exam, when you apply to any of these colleges, there is an application which will have your CV to be uploaded and the statement of purpose that needs to be done, as well as letters of recommendation to be sent to them. In addition, you need to also send the proof of money that you have to fund your education. All these things have to be done over a period of that 1 month, 2 months of application process. Please mail any queries that you have separately, individually, because I suddenly realized that there is one good thing about it is that there are a lot of students. The bad thing is that I'm not able to answer all of them. About 120, 150 students are asking questions one by one privately, and we are losing track of who is asking what. So therefore, please, thoda sa rahm khaiye aur mail kar dijiye. Email that I have just given it on the screen, Ankur. Again, I'm writing it down. My colleague's email ID is srinivas.a. He is the international education head of career launcher. That is Srinivas, and my name is ARKS. Between the two of us, we handle the MBA program in the country for career launcher. So please do that. Top programs, Himanshu, will be about 75-80%. Yes, you know, you can't attempt a pre-final year, Rahul. Sirish Gupta. You can leave it, but please understand that when you go into an interviews, people going to ask you, the professor is going to ask you, why have you left job? Why couldn't you do an aptitude program? Everybody else in the world does it without quitting jobs. Why did you have to quit? Are you saying you can't multitask? It's a very difficult question to answer. Unless your job is something like 16 hours job where you are not able to get any time at all, I wouldn't advise you to leave jobs. GMAT for you, my friend. Aditya Banerjee, please get in touch with Srinivas
my colleague. He will explain to you with 6 years of experience, three in TCS, three in public sector bank. You want to move on, boss, write seriously at GMAT. There are two choices available. Go abroad to Europe or the PGPEX programs in IIMs itself, which through GMAT you can apply. The last dates to apply will be August. Today we are talking about February, coming up, January, Feb, March, April, May. These 4 months you prepare seriously. Write the exam in May or June. Start application process in July. August, September apply. You will be ready to join in April next. The fees, Harish, is given for GMAT. For CAT also, it's about 30,000, 27,000, 30,000 for the night class program. Absolutely not, Himanshu. I can see the number of students will not be 200 there. Right? It will only be about 25, 30. So therefore, we can easily communicate and properly communicate to everybody. Akash, if you have 2 years of work experience, my bet is one more year of writing CAT makes sense. But now you should definitely also plan for GMAT. Aritra, GMAT is the right thing for you. Yes, Himanshu. Yes, obviously it will be. Sakshay, what you should do is, when you are in the second year, write your GMAT exam. Then apply for this program called the YLP program, the Young Leaders Program. This is for ISB in India. You will get the final admission by writing GMAT, writing the SOP, going through the interview, etc. But you will have the chance, then you can have to work for 2 years, and after 2 years, this admission will be valid for you. That is the way it is. Harish, every week we start a CAT coaching class. Every week we start a CAT coaching class. Please mail me your email ID. I will take care of that. Your PGDBF, Himanshu, I have no idea about ICSA back and thing. You have been asking that question for 10 times. Frankly, not much of an idea on that. For work experience, what aptitude course should one do? Either CAT or GMAT, one of them. Ideally CAT, Kishan. Top minimum programs, Himanshu, I am telling you, 75%. I think that's what I told last time around. Third year, Kanneganti, Nitish, you can write GMAT, but please realize this. There is no problem with writing GMAT, but you can apply for the YLP program. That's exactly what I was explaining to somebody else also. But you should write CAT again. The CAT is one which will get into the IIMs. Harika, if you have clear that you want to go abroad, then you should start preparing now, very clearly. From India, CAT, 1 year executive, 3 years experience, then also you should write a GMAT, Rohan. Whether or not you are in the industry, experience does matter if you want to go for a 1 year MBA program, Shavik. Kanneganti Nitesh, it will not get into an IIMs if you are in India. It will only get into your IIMs only if you have 5+ years of experience and go for a 1 year program, which doesn't make sense for you. You are don't have that kind of an experience. So GMAT will be only for abroad, for you, for MBA program. Definitely not Harshvardhan, it's an advantage, not a disadvantage. Aditya, you can, if you get into the top schools in the world, you will get a full loan. Don't worry about that. Yes, you have to search for jobs. But please understand, in India, the problem is that everybody looks for jobs alone. In the US, in Europe,
there are enough jobs available. You have to learn, you have to improve your skills so that you can get jobs easily. GMAT score is valid for 5 years. Nitish, you need to have any experience to do an MBA abroad. Ideally, it should be something in managerial also. Ideally. Definitely not Siddesh. It won't affect anything at all. Harshvardhan, US is the largest economy in the world even today with $18 trillion of economy. Second highest economy is still your China with about 10 trillion or less than that. So not having jobs is not an issue. It's just that you have to be very good at it. That's all. If you are in the top schools, I don't think it's an issue. Himanshu, no advantage or disadvantage for that. Rohan, GMAT score is valid for 2 year programs in the US. In India, it is not valid. It's only valid for a 1 year program. Kannigandi Nitesh, that's what I told you. There is no MIM program in India. There is only abroad. It's a program in the US only, not even in Europe. It's a 2 year program available for a lot of US colleges, and you need to write GMAT because it's an abroad college. In India, there's nothing called time, it's MBA, same thing. Please do that, Gaurav. Akshit, the 1 year program is the most known program in Europe and US, but if you go into US, the 2 year program also is very, very well known. Yaar Himanshu, yaar koi easy, difficult nahi hota hai. Marks kitna aata hai and relatively kitna aata hai, that's all that matters. It's not about easy. Please understand that easy to get a GMAT 750 is as difficult as getting a 99th percentile in CAT. Kishan Singh, you need to have a very strong work experience background. It can't be an ordinary thing. Second, you need to have something where some courses which you have taken up, which show that you are really, really serious about an MBA. It could be online courses through Coursera or any other digital marketing courses or finance courses, etc. kind of things. See, GMAT, syllabus-wise, somebody is asking this question, what is the difference between CAT and GMAT? See, GMAT has actually four sections, of which the main GMAT score is of two sections, ability and quantitative ability, which is called, so quantitative ability has two areas, problem solving and decision making, whereas the verbal ability has reading comprehension, grammar and critical reasoning. The level of difficulty for verbal is slightly higher than that of CAT. For quant, it will be lower than that of CAT. As far as CAT is concerned, the three sections, at least in the last few years, quantitative ability, data interpretation and logical reasoning, which is the same as integrated reasoning in GMAT, and verbal ability again. Verbal ability again has RC, critical reasoning, parajumbles, verbal reasoning, etc. So in that sense, is there a large difference between the two? Obviously not. It's like test cricket versus one day cricket versus T20 cricket. All of them are cricket only. The number of balls in the number of overs in the game changes. Thus, therefore, the way in which you look at the exam itself changes. That's all. Yes, Nitish, it is. Himanshu Yadav, can I get into Harvard at the age of 32? I don't know. Why are you saying you can't?
I mean, there is no reason why you can or can't, depending on your background. 700 is about 90 percentile, 91-92 percentile. Anytime you're leaving a job, Kishan will always have a problem unless you have a real reason for that. Nitish, I am surprised you have not even asked, you have not heard my questions or my entire thing. Same thing I said, yaar, MBA or MIM. MBA in India hai, 2-year program hai. MIM is a 2-year program in the US. MBA in the US is also a 2-year program, but it will be only available for people with more than 3-4 years experience, whereas MIM can be answered by can be applied to by anybody with less than 2 years experience. That is the broad difference. Himanshu, average age ka matlab 27 hai, somebody can be 40 also, somebody can be 25 also, right? Average ka matlab not that everybody is 27 years. Our school mein 10th class mein average padha hoga na, average ka matlab upar bhi hota hai, niche bhi hota hai. Anubhav Walia, very good question actually. If you are interested in GMAT, see, there is a, it's not even for a backup. You should prepare for CAT seriously. Try to crack the IIMs, but also write GMAT and apply for the YLP program for ISB. That would be a backup for you. Even otherwise, GMAT, because you are preparing when you are in the final year of your exam or when you are in college, your ability to prepare will be definitely higher than when you are working somewhere. Therefore, finishing this exam, both CAT and GMAT, GMAT especially, will ensure that this exam, worst case scenario, CAT mein nahi aaya, IIM mein nahi aaya, you know that it is available for 5 years for you. So therefore, it is possible. Himanshu, you are asking too many random questions. Please put a single mail and find out what are the questions you have. Because you are only asking questions, questions, questions. Please figure out all your, you give me your background, your scores, what you have done till now, everything. Send a mail to either Srinivas or me, one of us, we will reply to you all your questions. Because you are asking completely random questions from left to right. You are asking once Harvard jana hai 32 pe, once you are asking, no, there are only two, are you saying there are two Himanshu Yadavs? I am sorry, I am surprised, both of them are Himanshu Yadavs, I am surprised then. Okay, so here is what, whichever it is, if you have a lot of questions and a little worry, that is no problem, so I am going to answer them. Only thing is, please put in a structured question, wherein you also give me, all of you, this is for every one of you, please give me your background, 10th ka score kaha hai, kaha se kiya hai, 12th score kya hai, degree score kya hai, if you are working, where are you working, what is your CTC, I'll explain to you why I need this information. For example, you are already getting 10 lakhs, somebody said I am in Deutsche Bank, you are getting, let's say 10 lakhs, then I'll say, boss, agar you are already getting 10 lakhs, this is what you should do. Oh my God, there are 7 Himanshu Yadavs in today's class today. Oh boy. My apologies to all Himanshus now, suddenly. Because I am getting to see only Himanshus asking all random questions. I said, yeah, ho gaya kya hai Himanshu Yadav ko. I'm sorry guys. Interesting. All Himanshus have decided to do GMAT, it looks like. Oh, default Himanshu is coming. Okay. Interesting. Yes, Sirish, absolutely. Harshvardhan is asking 1/3 weightage for verbal and CAT. What is weightage? 50%. Anubhav, you need to apply somewhere. Date of YLP, I am not able to remember. But just write to Srinivas, he will tell you. But the application is, you need to apply. You need to write GMAT, submit the GMAT score. When you apply, you need to write a SOP also. State the purpose, why you want to apply kind of things. Okay? Srinivas has just given a ID placement. Okay, the kind of jobs, boss, if you are really looking at Rahul, if you are looking at Rahul Kolle, if you are looking at an MBA, is any core jobs that you can do, but which have a managerial bent of mind. That is one, or get to sales, finance, digital marketing, anything of that sort. Sir, there is no advantage here. GMAT CAT, I mean, there is nothing like advantage. This is one Himanshu Yadav, I don't know which Himanshu Yadav I am answering. But the advantages of GMAT or CAT, it's nothing like that. Advantages. Both of them have their own purposes. It is your requirement which will decide whether you should write CAT or GMAT or both. So here is where my simple submission has been for the last few minutes. Please send, depending on what your background is, I think we will be able to help you out. GMAT, sir. Mr. Ankur Agarwal, clearly GMAT. Or CAT with IIMs, XLRI, FMS. These are the ones. Kishan Singh, apply online course is the best course for you, therefore. No, all the PPTs are done. If you have any questions, please ask. Okay, so that's it for me for the day, friends. I think it's been exactly 1 hour and 10-15 minutes. Thank you for all your patience. If you have any more questions, all of you, please do write to either of us, srinivas.a@careerlauncher.com or ask@careerlauncher.com. We will be absolutely happy to help you out. Okay? Wish you all the very best and see you in the classes online too. Hey, my apologies to all the Himanshus who have come in because the default of Himanshu, it looked like seven random questions are coming from the same person types. Okay? I hope you understood that and we'll get in touch. Thanks. Thank you, Anubhav. Thank you, everyone. Thanks, Himanshu. Oh, which Himanshu, I don't know, but all Himanshus actually. Varun, send a mail to me. I will definitely help you on that. Thank you, Vidya. You are supposed to message. Harsh, thank you very much again. Absolutely, I believe, yes, that answer is you will get jobs if you are good. There is zero doubt about it. Thank you, Sirish. Thanks to every one of you. Nice to tormentors. Hey, Harshvardhan. Hi. Rushabh was just calling me today only. I have to call him back. When I was taking the class, he was calling me. He and Hitesh are my very good friends. Right, Ishan?
I think we can stop the recording.